Hi, welcome back to PokerNews.com, powered by Club GG. You're here with Lauren Tracy, and this is your WSOP wrap-up for day 10. We look back on a day that has seen two gold bracelets awarded with huge prize pools to come with them. First up, Bradley Jansen has defeated Jeremy Maloud in a heads-up play to claim the gold bracelet in the 1500 six-handed no-limit hold'em. He took home a breathtaking $313,403, and the three-day event did attract 1,450 entries to generate a $1,935,750 prize pool. We caught up with Bradley after his victory, and in his words, he told Poker News that it feels great. I've gone through this moment in my head many times before, and when it actually gets here, it's unreal. Last night, I thought about it a lot, and I thought about what I was going to do and how I would react. It's easy to get ahead of yourself. It's just a really special day. And what a truly special day it really is. Huge congratulations to Bradley. And now moving on to someone who's no stranger at collecting gold bracelets, we take a look at what was an almighty 11-hour battle on the final table of the $10,000 No Limit Hold'em Championship. John Monette emerging as the victor to claim his fourth WSOP bracelet, along with that $245,680 prize pool. This was by defeating Nate Silver heads up. This is Monette's first Hold'em bracelet after winning the 2500 8 game in 2011, the 5007 card stud in 2012, and the 10,000 No Limit 2-7 Low Ball Draw Championship. Monette started the day with the shortest stack in the tournament, but he did come out victorious in the end. The star-studded final table also included the likes of Terence Chan, Jason Somerville, John Ransner, and Kevin Song. Congratulations, John. And in other news, day 1B of the 1500 Millionaire Maker has concluded. It attracted a field of 2,762 players at the Ryu Hotel and Casino, and only 609 bagged up chips for day 2. Stephen Song bagged the Millionaire Maker chip lead with 431,000 chips. Song already has one bracelet and will be looking for number 2 in the next couple of days. Will he bring it home though? Stay tuned to see if Song can hold on to that chip lead here at PokerNews.com. And the second day of the 2500 Mixed Triple Low Ball has completed with 12 players remaining. They completed the redraw for the final two tables, played one hand of Budagi, and then bagged up for the night. Jason Daly currently holds onto the chip lead with 1,595,000 chips. Jose Paz does lead the 18 players who made it through the 10 hours of play in day 1 of the 10,000 7 card stud championship. He has a huge stack of 341,000 chips. Paz, who is after his first WSOP bracelet, is trailed by fellow Big Stacks Jason Gola with 292,500 chips. There were a number of big names in the field, however, who didn't make it today too, including Daniel Negreanu, Sean Deep, and Scott Seaver. Day 2 will commence on the 10th of October at 2 p.m. local time, and levels will increase to 90 minutes in duration. Stay tuned on all of our socials and of course PokerNews.com for all the latest updates and information. I'm Lauren Tracy, thank you for watching, I'll see you guys tomorrow.